This is my Montgomery Ward's Power 2 Power Team from 1983. This is a Eureka canister that was privately labeled for a defunct store called Montgomery Ward's, a department store that was very popular in the 60s, 70s, and 80s. And thus we have this canister. And I got this from a vacuum shop basement. I got a few vacuums from him before, and I was lucky enough to find this there in such nice shape for a vacuum that's 35 years old. And he had some mold issues down there, so it had a little bit of a musty odor, so I had to clean it up. But surprisingly, the vacuum itself, it's common to see lots of rust inside the bagged compartment in these old Eureka canisters, but surprisingly, there's really only a little bit of surface rust back here, and that's it, really. It even still has the tool pack cover, but you can see that it's cracked in a few places. Again, very common to see, so you really can't lift it. You just have to lift the whole thing off. It came with a full set of attachments, dusting brush, floor tool, and then the upholstery tool, crevice tool. So that was a surprise for me to see. It has a very powerful motor. It has a dual stage land motor, which means that it's very powerful, but also rebuildable if it ever needed to be. When I took, when I looked at the motor, I noticed that there was an unusually large amount of dust and dirt down there, so I'm going to guess that at some point this vacuum was used either without a bag or with a bag that had burst and they didn't realize it. Also has obviously a Eureka power nozzle, very interesting Eureka power nozzle with a Vibro Groomer brush roll with very stiff bristles. This is a very good cleaning brush roll. It's probably one of the best power nozzles ever devised. And I also like the design of the wheels with when you push down on this, it makes the wheels basically glide across the carpet, so it's a lot easier to push on higher piles of carpet like this. And the hose is also in very good shape. There's a couple small cracks right here, but it's not anything really that major. So overall, it's a really nice vacuum. The only issue really with these is that they never really made good bags for these vacuums that have multiple layers to trap dust. So you really, if you want to get a good bag in this vacuum, you have to basically make one. Because the only bags they ever made for these are basically one layer paper bags, and those leak a very large amount of dust. And I personally wouldn't recommend using a machine with a one layer paper bag. So, without further ado, here's the Montgomery Ward Power 2, as they like to call it. This was like the middle of the line Montgomery Ward canister. They had a more expensive model that had a headlight and a chrome head, as well as a speed selector switch right here, but this one does not have that. But that's alright. You don't see a lot of these Montgomery Ward canisters around. You don't really see many of the Eureka canisters around anymore, but especially not these. That is the Montgomery Ward canister. I hope you enjoyed the video.